Hi, this is Ramesh Reddy. Today's session I would like to explain the database users and administrator. So already in the previous session we discussed the database architecture. So same here also. We have the different users like Navy users, application programmers, sophisticated users, and roles of database administrator. He is also one of the user. He has the authorization of entire database need to change and doing the access everything under control of this database administrator. So here we have the different users like Navy users. Navy users are unsophisticated users who interact with the system by invoking one of the application program written previously. That means they cannot write any programs. They are not experts. They cannot write any programs. Simply they can use what available the application programs like tellers, agents, and web users. And the next one is application programmers. They are the experts who write application programs for invoking the database system. And the next one is sophisticated users. They can interact with the system without writing programs through database query language. That means they cannot write any application programs even though they can interact with the database system by different query languages like SQL. So they can analyze the data by using those. And the specialized users, they write specialized database application that do not fit into the relational data processing, sorry, traditional processing. And the next one, database user like DBA. So he is a person who has the control over the system. Is called as database administrator. The functionalities of database administrator, first one is schema definition. That means they can define the schemas by executing DDL commands. Schema definition is nothing but what is the relation name and what are the data types and what are the data of these attributes are accessing and what are the constraints we are defining on this each and every attribute. This is called as a database schema. This schema is defined by database administrator with the help of DDL commands. And next one is storage structure and accessing methods methods. So here we need to access the data through the computer hard disk or display terminal. So this is called a storage structure and access method. And the next one is granting of authorization for data access. Granting of authorization means different users need to access the data. They need some privileges. Privileges is nothing but a read authorization, write authorization, whereas update authorization like this. So this is done by the database administrator, and every database administrator need to do some routine works. These are periodically backing up of data, either tapes or remote servers to prevent the loss of data. So this is done by the database administrator regularly. We need to check the storage is available or not. If it is full, we need to check backup the data in some particular intervals like 1 year, 2 years. Based on the transaction, they need to backup the data. And he is also ensures that free disk space. And he is also monitor the jobs running smoothly, and it increases the performance or decreasing the performance like this. And the next one is specialty databases. Special databases is nothing but which resides in the computer's RAM, is nothing but random access memory or physical storage media, such as a file system, and that is intended to store specially related data and metadata. So this information is organized for purpose of computer driven storage, search, retrieval, manipulation, and calculation. So this is about specialty of databases. And the next one is history of database system. So history is nothing but when the database is started and how day-to-day implements are going on. So this we can discuss here in 1950s and 1960s. During these 10 years, what happened? So in the days, we used magnetic tapes for storage and data processing. So whatever your data stored in the system, that can be stored on the magnetic tapes. And at that time, we can give the input through punched cards. The next one is late 1960s and 1970s. So here, hard disks are allowed to direct access data. So we can store and retrieve from hard disk. And that days we can use the most popular data models called as network and hierarchical data models. These are most popular models on that 1960s and 70s. And that days EF chord defines a model called as relational data model, which is more powerful. Even nowadays, we are also using this relational data model. In 1980s, IBM first defined this SQL product. SQL is nothing but structured query language, and database system also provides support for parallel database systems and distributed database systems, and also it supports for object oriented database systems. In 1990s, the database system may be one step forward. There it can support for multi terabyte data warehouses. So these data warehouses are mostly used for business purpose, to analyze the business and make the decisions. So it also supports for decision support system as well as data mining applications. And in 1990s, database system supports for World Wide Web. So through World Wide Web, they can do some online business like web commerce or e-commerce. In 2000s, the database system may go forward one step, and that is called as XML. It supports for XML, extensible markup language, and we get the data from XML by using SQL standards. And also, the database system supports for automated database administrator. So, this is the database system's history. So you can have any doubts, you can come with me by my using my mobile number or my mail ID. Thank you. Thank you very much.